Hey everybody, Tom Barnish, Chicago scene in Bedford Park, right along I-55, technically at the Metropolitan Water Reclamation District of Greater Chicago. And I have a question for you. You ever wonder where all this stuff goes when you flush it down the toilet? Well, it goes into something like this when it rains really hard. This is phase two at the McCook Reservoir. Phase one is kind of where that sun's peeking out right now. We're gonna get over there and talk to Kevin in a second, but all that's gotta go somewhere and somebody's gotta clean it. So that's why people want you to make sure that you're responsible by the things that you flush down the toilet, because somebody's gotta clean it. And when it's cleaned and taken from out of here in our water treatment plants, it's dropped off here. It dries out for a year and a half. We're gonna talk to Kevin all about it for the Chicago scene here in Bedford Park. So let's go say hi to Kevin, shall we? All right, it's far and few between when this reservoir is filled, but this is part of a whole entire engineering feat called TARP, and I'm here with my friend Kevin. How you doing, Kevin?
Good, thank you.
So Kevin, continuing the long tradition of Chicago managing our water and where it all goes, this reservoir behind you is one big step in phase one of phase two down in this McCook reservoir area, right?
It is, yes. It's part of our tunnel and reservoir plan.
So what does TARP stand for people, and what is it better known by most Chicagoans?
Most people call it the deep tunnel system, but the official name is TARP, and it stands for Tunnel and Reservoir Plan. And it consists of 110 miles of deep tunnels that are like up to 300 feet below ground. They capture combined sewer overflows and bring them to reservoirs like this. This is the McCook Reservoir.
So when you say combined sewer overflow, Chicago is an older city and we do have combined sewers. And that basically means the water that you flush in the toilet is the same water that's coming off the streets all going into one big sewer, right?
Yes, that's right. And that's, you know, during dry weather it works great, but during big storms like we had the last 24 hours, it can overwhelm our treatment plants. And previously the combined sewage and stormwater would then overflow into one of the area waterways, causing pollution, potentially backing up and causing flooding. And so that's why we created this pollution and flood control project we call TARP.
Right, and so this, like you were saying, we just had a big rain event here in Chicago, and this reservoir behind you, about approximately how deep and how long is it? Just to give people an idea of what they're looking at here.
Sure. So first of all, this is just stage one of the McCook Reservoir. We have plans to increase the size. So it's 3.5 billion gallons. That's what it can hold. When we complete stage two in 2029, that'll add an extra 6.5 billion gallons, and we'll get to 10 billion total. So the width of it is between about 200 and 1,000 feet. It varies. The length here of stage one alone is over 4,000 feet. When we get to the end of stage two, it's a total of about 8,000 feet. And we can hold up to 270 feet worth of water. So it goes down approximately 320 feet below ground is the bottom of this reservoir.
Right, and you were talking earlier about I'm going to swing over here.
Yeah.
But there's a little light way out there, or not a light, a sign way out there. And it's that white sign, and there's another one underneath it. What does that mean for people who are looking at this? Because that kind of tells you guys where you're at with how deep the water is and how high it is, right?
It does, yeah. So it's just a visual. It tells us, so there's two white signs that you can see there. The top one is minus 30, and that's the highest elevation that we want in this reservoir, and that's completely full.
And that's pretty close.
It's getting close. The other elevation, the other sign there is elevation minus 50, telling us that we have about 20 feet of water left. What you can't see right now because of the water is that those signs go all the way down to minus 285, which is at the floor of the reservoir.
Right, and that's also, you're using the measuring stick of where Lake Michigan sits on as far as the plane that you measure from, right?
Yeah, that's a good point. So zero would be Lake Michigan's level. We call that the city of Chicago's datum. So the water in here is 50 feet below the level of Lake Michigan right now.
And that's incredible. And that is just from like 2 days worth of water. You said this was pretty empty up until we had this big rain event. And in a matter of 2 days, this thing is almost filled, which I think is a great example to explain to people how much water really does come off a runoff from our sewers and also our flushing the toilets and taking showers. But that you said, you know, the majority of the water that we're looking at right behind you there is from all the rain that we've had, right?
Yes, yeah, I mean, it's a lot of water. Chicago is such a flat area. It doesn't really infiltrate water into the ground very well. It's been paved over. Even before it was paved over, it was mostly clay soils, which is why it was so swampy. So there's really not a lot of places for the water to go, especially, you know, the polluted water that we're capturing now. So building a reservoir like this really helps give it a place to go that's not into polluting a waterway or backing up into people's basements.
For sure. And for people who are wondering, how does this water get here? Where does it come from? It comes from as far north as Wilmette, right? And it's also being fed further west and north, what'd you say, from Mount Prospect. And those two tunnels kind of come down from Wilmette all the way through the city and empty out here and all the way up from Mount Prospect, combining into this space here, correct?
Right. So we actually have four separate tunnel systems. And two of the larger ones are the ones that feed into here. The one we call Mainstream comes all the way from Wilmette through downtown and out along the Sanitary Ship Canal out into here. And then the other one follows under the Des Plaines River and basically takes water from the western suburbs and into this reservoir. It fills fairly frequently, about four or five times a year. And then as soon as the storm is over, our treatment plant starts, we start pumping it back to our treatment plant and we clean it and put it back out in the waterway. So we drain it down at about 20 to 30 feet per day right now and get ready for the next storm.
And when you close it off, you have like these gates almost that closed to not let the water into the reservoir, right?
Yeah, so that's a good point. We do have a finite amount of water that we can handle right now. It's 3.5 billion gallons in this stage one of McCook. And when it does approach the top, we have to close what we call wheel gates. Mm-hmm. Now, these wheel gates isolate that 33-foot tunnel. So the 33-foot tunnel that enters into the reservoir splits into two chambers. In each of those chambers, we have what we call wheel gates that are 20 foot wide and 30 feet high. And they're about 3 feet thick. And they're made out of steel, and they isolate the reservoir from the tunnel. So at that point, you know, whatever we capture in the tunnel fills up the tunnel, and unfortunately we go back to the situation we were in before we built this whole system, where we have CSOs
right back into the waterways,
which is a
reality of what we are, of our region, right? I mean, can only do so much.
Also why we're continuing to expand this reservoir and make it 10 billion gallons by 2029.
And that's phase two that people are looking at right now. And for people who might want to know, like, how does this not get into the groundwater? You guys have done something where you almost tiled off the bottom, kind of, right? With these holes that you drilled in the ground.
Right. So we built this reservoir with the Army Corps of Engineers. They're our partner on it. And they had one contract to build what they call a grout curtain all the way around the entire perimeter of this reservoir. And what they did was drilled 3 to 4 inch holes down anywhere from 200 to 500 feet down into the ground, and they filled these holes up with grout under pressure, which is basically like caulking all the cracks in the rock to prevent the water that we capture, in the polluted water that we capture in the reservoir, from escaping and polluting the groundwater. It also helps keep clean groundwater from coming into the reservoir and us, you know, taking up our capacity.